Everybody take your Bibles and turn to Romans chapter 12, verse 19. The title of my sermon tonight is Vengeance is Mine, I Will Repay, saith the Lord. Now, if we're going to have any kind of camp meeting this week, we're going to have to lay down a few rules. Now, the number one rule is this. There ain't going to be no feuding this week. I mean, no time, nowhere, nobody.
Rufus, it sure is hard here, way back here in the last row, ain't it? Clovis, look out the back of the tent across the river. What do you see? Hey, it's getting dark already. Not that, Beanhead. Look over at Moonshine Mountain. See the lights? Plain as turkey's teeth. Do you think it's Polecat Jack? It's gotta be. Let's go meet our hero. Where'd our hero go? There's a light we've been following right there. That's mighty strange. That lantern's just hanging in a tree. I wonder how it got there. It sure is spooky out here. And it's so quiet. Too quiet.
Go get 'em, Rosebud.
Oh, what is it? That skunk sitting on that feller's head is spraying us. Oh, it's all over me. I'm gonna gag. What a smell. I'm covered with it. Yeah.
Good shot, Rosebud.
Thank you, Governor.
I just love that new fragrance.
Are you...
Polecat Jack.
Oh, I can't believe it. Is it really you? Could I shake your hand?
I reckon.
Oh, thank you. I've been dreaming of this day all my life.
Oh, Mr. Polecat, it's just so mighty fine to meet you. So mighty fine.
Yep, I reckon. Could I have my hand back?
I'm sorry.
And we're sorry about the smell, too. You can just thank that skunk of sitting on top of your head. She just let us have it.
Thank you kindly, Rosebud. You did a good job.
Don't mention it, Governor.
Good job?
How long since you younguns had a bath?
Oh, about 2-3 weeks, maybe.
I knew it. I told you that was the problem, didn't I, Polecat?
I reckon.
Did we do something wrong?
Listen to him, playing innocent. Did we do something wrong? It's as plain as a nose on your face, says I.
What?
Well, we could smell you all coming as soon as you started crossing the river.
You're pulling my leg.
Nope. It got so strong my nose hairs about caught on fire.
I didn't know we smelled that bad.
Some people can be so insensitive.
It's even worse than I'm saying. It smelled just like a... I can't even say the dirty word.
Oh, he's talking about soap. S-O-I-P, soap. That's why I had to spray you with me perfume to get rid of that awful smell.
Now you boys smell just like a rose garden, don't you?
That ain't exactly the first word that came to mind.
It's so strong.
Ah, thank you, Junior. It's me own special brand of perfume. 100% natural, of course.
Well, reckon me and Rosebud better be moving along. We got a lot of supplies to carry.
Where are you headed for?
I'm headed to my hideout, I reckon.
Your hideout? Could we see it? You're our hero.
Ain't nobody done seen my hideout afore.
I don't think it'd be a good idea, neither.
Oh, please, Mr. Polecat. We won't be no trouble at all. Fact is, we can help you carry your supplies.
That'd be mighty nice. I was wondering how I was gonna get everything. Anybody following you?
Nope. Not a soul knows where we are. Everybody's at the camp meeting.
I doubt now, Bowcats. It's a bit risky to me, I'd say.
How we gonna get all these supplies back to the hideout?
I told you we shouldn't be so greedy, says I.
Oh, please, Mr. Polecat. We won't be no trouble. Promise.
And we won't tell a soul about your hideout, neither. You're our hero. Oh, please.
Tell you what. How would you two like to be partners with the great Polecat Jack?
Partners? Yippee! You hear that, Clovis? Partners with Polecat Jack.
Rufus, you get them two big old sacks of corn. And Clovis, you can grab that pile of firewood.
Oh my goodness, these sacks are so heavy.
Am I supposed to carry all this firewood?
I reckon. I'll get this little old bag of sugar and the lantern. Let's get.
Tally-o!
Let's go on in.
What is this place?
Rumbly, crumbly coal mine, of course.
Rumbly, crumbly coal mine? But it was condemned years ago.
I condemned it myself.
But don't it cave in all the time?
You better believe it does, Julia. This ain't a safe place at all, says I.
Ain't a lot of folks been killed in mining accidents?
Yep. Kind of cuts down on the traffic. Now let's go ahead and put your corn and firewood in this here mining car.
Oh, that feels better.
Oh, my arm was about to fall off.
Now everybody climb in and sit down.
Get in the car?
Yep.
It's kind of small.
Make room for me.
Ow, you're sitting on my legs.
I'm sorry. It's only supposed to be a two-seater.
Ow, I just love this part of the trip.
Okay, I'm putting out the light.
What?
We're going in the dark.
I'm afraid so. Open flames tend to cause terrible explosions in here.
Pull down the safety bar, Rosebud.
Roger.
Why do we need a safety bar?
It will hold us in when we go topsy-turvy.
Upside down in the dark?
Pull the lever, Rosebud.
Oh, I just love roller coasters.
Oh, I'm dying. I know I'm dying.
Am I still in one piece? What'd we hit?
That was just a big pile of straw we used to slow us down a bit. Nice touch, ain't it?
Sorry about all the screaming.
That's why we call our roller coaster the Idenala Idenala.
It's the only way through the mountain. Welcome to Idenala.
And in conclusion, I want to remind you of the text of this here sermon. It's found in Romans chapter 12, verse 19. Now let's all read it together.
Vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord.
And now, Captain Patch and his crew have prepared another special for us.